Wear OS 4 for the first gen Pixel Watch is here, and I'll tell you right up front, it's not super exciting. For a major OS update, there's not that much new for the first Pixel Watch, but Wear OS 3.5 didn't have any huge issues for me, and Wear OS 4 does solve some of those pain points. I'll be doing a 1-year review for the Pixel Watch to see if Wear OS 4 changes things around for me in terms of battery life and daily performance, so definitely subscribe to the channel if you want to see that video. Alright, let's get started with my favorite new feature, which is Transfer Watch. This allows you to pair your Pixel Watch to a new phone without having to factory reset the watch itself. It's super seamless, you get to keep all your watch faces, tiles, and settings while being paired to your new phone. I switch phones pretty often and it got really annoying to reset and reset up this watch every time, so I'm personally really happy about this feature. It's an expansion of the improved backup and restore system too, so if you need to switch to a newer Pixel Watch, it's a lot easier for that too since you can keep all your watch faces and settings. There's a new Google Calendar app which will be pre-installed on your Pixel Watch with this update. It's now a fully baked version of the original Agenda app. Just like before, you get event and task notifications, but in the app you can now view up to 30 days of your schedule and start navigation to event locations straight from the watch. The tile hasn't changed much, but the event details seem a little more detailed. Notifications on the watch are also getting a bit of an upgrade. The notification system now has smart link recognition for phone numbers and addresses, so you'll automatically get options to call or message a number or get directions to an address. There's also embedded media previews so you can see pictures and GIFs and messages without opening the notification or app itself. We also get access to some new safety features just like on Pixel phones. You can fill in your emergency info so you can easily show or send your medical info to emergency services. Safety check and emergency sharing are now on the Pixel Watch too. If you didn't know already, you can use safety check to start a timer for yourself when you're walking home late at night. If you don't stop the timer and you're possibly in an emergency situation, the Pixel Watch will automatically share your location to your emergency contacts so they can check up on you. These little safety features can be super essential depending on where you live, so I'm so glad it made its way onto the first gen Pixel Watch. Probably the most important changes coming with Wear OS 4 are all the under-the-hood fixes, including software bugs, performance, and battery life improvements. These are things I'll have full thoughts on during my 1-year review, but for now, I think it's too early to say. I will say that I've already ran into a couple of crashes in the settings, so it's not a perfect start, but we'll see how things go once I test it out some more. Other than those things, we got a faster, more reliable text-to-speech engine for voice typing, better accessibility features like bold text and better magnification support, and also better balance for the audio coming from the on-device speakers. So all in all, the Wear OS 4 update for the Pixel Watch is pretty low-key. This isn't the most surprising, considering software updates for smartwatches are never too groundbreaking, but I'm glad us first-gen owners are finally getting some attention here. If you updated already, let me know in the comments what you think of the update so far, and also let me know what you'd like me to cover for my upcoming 1-year review video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.